Ornaments of Flower Festival. It's actually done to celebrate. We had a king called Mahabali in Kerala, state of Kerala. That was years ago. So he was the king that ruled in Kerala, and he was a brilliant king, and people absolutely loved him. So the god and goddesses got a bit scared. They says, "Oh God, people seems to love him more than they love us." Because you know the way in a Hindu culture, god and goddesses, like, you know, we have different gods and goddesses for everything. You know, you name it, we have them. So they went to the highest god and complained to him, says, "Look, we have to do something about this. You know, he's a demon king. He's a demon. So the people can't be worshipping him above us. Like, they can't be thinking, like, he is the, you know." So they went and said to him, "You have to do something about this." So the god came down to earth as a Brahmin. Brahmin is someone who is like a priest, you know, looks after our temples and who gives education. So obviously everybody respects a man like that. So he came down to the king and, you know, he says, the king is a very generous person. So he says, "What can I do for you?" So he says, "I just need three. I need three wishes." So he says, "That's fine." So he says, "I need just need 3 feet of land from you." So the king says, "Yeah, you can have 3 feet of land from me." So he takes, so he grows into this big gigantic, you know, giant, and he takes 1 feet, he takes the land, the whole earth. The second one, he takes the whole, the sky, and the third one, he puts the head. He's nowhere else to put, so the king puts his head down and says, "You can take me." That's how generous he is, even though he's a demon. So the god says, "Look, you're the nicest person, even though you're a demon." So he says, "I'll give you a boon. You can, you know, wish what you want." So he says, "Right, only thing I want is can I come back to see my people once a year?" And he says, "Right, I give you that." So that's what Onam is about. So it's a harvest festival that the king comes back to see his people once a year, and that's what Onam is about. So people do that. So what they do is that day they get, you know, it's like a 10-day festival. The first day they start to put the flower carpet. They start in the middle, and then they work their way out for the 10 day. It can end up being you know, like a big gigantic flower carpet, and that's the way it happens. So this is the outfit that the ladies would wear, and this is called mundu. It's kind of, you know, the what the men would wear with the shirt, and this is a two-piece outfit that the ladies would wear with the blouse and the skirt, this undergarment, and they would wear that. It's called setemundu, and that's a blouse, and then this is the bottom, and then on the top they would put the wee cover, just like a sari. Every state wears a different outfit. So this is from my state in Kerala. So this is what they would wear for Onam. And Hindus in Kerala for Onam, it's not just a Hindu thing. The Christians would do equally. They, you know, because Mahabali, the king, looked after everybody, so everybody done it. For the last 10, 15 years, the Muslims stopped taking part in it because their religious leaders told them that they shouldn't take part in it, so they stepped out of it. But before that, all religion took part in Onam. It was something that everybody took part in. It was something that it was a, you know, it was a communal thing. It wasn't a religious thing, Onam. So Christians, big part in it, same as Hindus do. So that's where Onam is. So on that day, we all get, you know, get up in the early morning. We do have flower carpet, shower, put new clothes on. That's the thing we have to do. Everybody does that. Brand new clothes on this year. And then we wear all new, you know, jewelry. Everything has to be new, nothing old. So everything has to be new. And then we do a feast. It's a big feast. We have like 26 different, you know, we cook like 25 different, you know, food, like all vegetarian, no meat that day. So it's all vegetarian food. And we eat it on a banana leaf. So that's what Onam is all about. And then after all that is done, ladies all, you know, we light the lamb, because in the Hindu religion we do a lamb. And then they all dance around the lamb. And you know, that's the whole thing about Onam. It's about actually inviting the king back into our lives and showing, you know, like showing him that we appreciate what he's, you know, like we still love him and we're still inviting him back into our lives.